I've never seen a diamond in the flesh. I cut my teeth on wedding rings in the movies. We crave a different kind of buzz. Let me be your ruler. You can call me Queen Bee. And baby, I'll rule. Let me live that.
This is Dallin Grundvig reporting for Cave TV, teaching you how to keep it clean. The administration has noticed that a lot of students are neglecting to clean up after themselves at lunch, so Cave TV is giving them a hand in getting the word out. Right, I'm here with Mr. Biolo, and we are talking about cleaning up during lunchtime. Why is that important for the students to be able to do that?
Well, it's important just because we want students to take pride in the school. And when you clean up at lunch, that shows that you're proud to be a caveman, proud to be here at American Fork High School. We got this brand new facility, and we want to keep it clean, so we hope that everybody cleans up all their trash and throws it in the trash cans.
Just like Mr. Biolo said, it is our duty as cavemen and as people to be courteous enough to clean up after ourselves, and cleaning up isn't as hard as you might think. Right, I'm here with Drake Foltz, and we're going to be talking a little bit about cleaning up at lunchtime. So do you think it's valid, I guess, for the administration to ask the students to clean up after themselves?
Yeah, they should be responsible for their own mess. I don't really have much experience with litter. I clean up after myself.
So this is an exemplary student here. The easiest way to keep it clean is to simply throw away your tray. But the biggest problem is what's left. After you leave a table, check it for leftover fruit or vegetable cups or milk cartons or even any bits of food. This can really help both our cleanup crews and our fellow students.
I'm Blake with KTV. We have Madeline here from the Forecaster. What is going on this week?
We have a lot of awesome stuff going on this year. Check us out, especially on Monday. That's when we're releasing all of our stuff from the previous week about homecoming. We're going to have some awesome pictures that were taken during the dance for you guys to download and take down for free. We're going to have some gossip about some of the teachers, dating do's and don'ts, some awesome alumni stuff. So go check us out at theforecaster.com. Follow us on Twitter at theforecaster. Like our Facebook page.
Remember, you heard it first from KTV. I'm Blake, signing out.
Hey, cavemen, this is Cameron Crowther here with KTV. We're just going to ask a few people what they're doing for homecoming. Are you going to homecoming?
I am.
Okay. Are you planning anything for a day date or anything?
I think we're going ice skating, but I can't really ice skate, so...
Hogo Zoo.
I don't know what we're doing yet, but I heard it's gonna be awesome, so...
We're going ice skating. We're going to the Space Center.
I'm actually going to the Peaks to go ice skating with my pals.
How did you ask your girl?
She really likes Crazy Bread, and so I like... It'd make me go crazy if she went to homecoming with me like that, and a bunch of Crazy Bread all over the place.
I got 40 balloons. And then I put my name in 9 of them. And then she had to pop them to figure out who it was.
At the football game, the announcer guy just asked me if I'd go to homecoming with Tyler Miller, and I said yes.
I put a rabbit in a box, a real rabbit, and said I would jump for joy if you hopped to homecoming with me.
I did a reverse Cinderella story. I left my shoe at her house, and she had to find me at school with only one shoe on.
I just gave her this drawing that I made about... Earth and the stars, and I said, and I put on the back, it says, "We will reach the stars if you go to homecoming with me."
You guys are creative cavemen. I'm excited to see you guys at the football game tonight and at the dance tomorrow. This is Cameron signing off.
Hi, my name's Stormy, and welcome to the first ever Cave TV versus the World. So this is how Cave TV versus the World works. We have three Cave TV reporters, Devin, Blake, and myself, against three color guard captains, and we are going to have a rifle spin toss. So Blake.
I'm going to pick red hair Maddie.
So the rules of this is the first one to drop loses. Okay. Maddie's off her start, and she looks lovely while doing it. And Blake drops! Oh, switch your beats and sit in that lunch if you're cheating. Ready, set, go. Break it down for me, fellas. And Jeff's off to a lovely start. And there goes Maddie. Good job, Jeff. And how do you feel?
Awesome. I felt like I did my hardest. And now we have Stormy versus Hannah. On your mark, get set, go.
It's an epic competition. They're making a good run. Can they keep it going? Stormy's cheating.
I am doing awesome at this. You see this? This is pure skill. They should just hire me on right now.
She's going one-handed.
Oh. And we have a winner.
And Hannah wins.
I'm last longer than both you guys.
How does it feel?
Oh, wonderful. So, as you guys could tell, the color guard won. It was close, though. We almost beat them. I promise. Sorta. So, this is the color guard, Hannah, Maddie, and Maddie, and I'd like them to tell us a little about their team, club, sport.
So, a color guard is just a group of really hardworking girls, and we all love the sport so much, and we perform this Friday at homecoming. Come see us.
This is Stormy with KTV, and I'm saying have a wonderful day, cavemen. Break it down for me, fellas.